home. I have to get him out of the car and put on his swimming diapers to get him ready to start swimming. Switching my son's swimming class last minute, so now I'm on the rush to get there on time. So he's normally in the 4 p.m. class, but now I'm bringing him at 11 a.m. because I have other stuff to do today and then we won't make it there for 4 o'clock. So I was like, let me get him in there earlier so he can get his swimming done, because after this week he won't be going swimming until we come back in a month's time. So I just want to get his last swimming class out the way. Oh my god, I look a hot mess, but these are things that you have to do for your children.
So we finally arrived at my son's swimming school. About to get him out the car and put on his swimming diapers again, ready to start swimming.
So my son is in his swim pants. He is ready to go for his swimming class.
So my baby is all ready for swimming. The swimmers that he have on now, the school actually gives them one for free when you register them, which is really good. It's a reusable swimmer diaper, so basically it holds everything while they're in the pool, so nothing gets out, but you can always reuse it. So all you have to do is pop it in the washer, dry it, and then it's ready to go again. He goes to school, swimming school, once a week. So
also, please be reminded to bring all of your belongings out to the pool deck so our staff can clean the chairs as well. Thank you.
He is obsessed with the girl that makes the announcement. He's always looking at her. Look at him. So here in the video, as you can see, it's actually the instructor, me, and my son in the pool. Nobody was with him in the class at this time. They do have group classes, and then they do have individual classes and private classes as well. I just chose to go in the pool with my son, just so we can have that mother-son bond as he swims. Just so, you know, he has a familiar face that he's seeing. He does pretty well. He's been going to swim school since he was 3 months. At the end of going 4 months, actually. So he's actually doing good. He's starting to kick his feet more. As you can see, we still need to get him the hang of swimming with his hands. He always wants to reach for something, but he doesn't do it the right way, and you can't blame him. He's still a baby, so he's learning. But the reason why I enrolled him is because he loves water. He absolutely loves water. So with living in Florida, drowning is very high when it comes to children. So I really wanted him to get into the swimming classes very early. And the fact that he loves water, I definitely wanted to make sure that he gets a head start on learning how to swim. It's never too early and it's never too late to teach your children how to swim. But I just thought I could get a jump start on helping him learn to swim here. So I'm finally home and I am gonna make some pasta for dinner. This is a new recipe that I started making probably like 3 months ago, and I really fell in love with it. So I'm gonna show you guys today. So here are two seasons that I did use. I did prepare the shrimp and the chicken before I got started. Always remember, before I go on, to wash your hands. So I did go ahead, prepare the shrimp and the chicken, as well as I cut up some peppers as well. So here I am seasoning it. With the seasoning, it is seafood seasoning and blackened seasoning. So I just put that on there. I didn't measure it. I'm Jamaican, we don't measure seasoning. So I just mixed it up. I know I didn't overpower with the seasoning or put too much. So I'm just blending that in with my hand, making sure everything gets all seasoned up between the shrimp and the seasoning. And here I'm going to go ahead and add some all-purpose seasoning as well, just to give it a little more flavor. You can find this in any local Jamaican store. I haven't really seen it in Publix or Winn-Dixie, but that seasoning is in Bravo and also Broward Meat. So here I am just seasoning it up. Make sure it's well marinated into the shrimp and chicken. So I'm getting that taken care of. So that's done right there.
So I'm complete with season.
So I am going ahead and doing a voiceover because my son is crying and he's watching Barney in the back and making a whole lot of noise. But right here, as you guys see, I did forget to cut up my asparagus. So I am just throwing away the ends. You don't need the ends. You just need to wash it and cut it up small. I am going to add this to the pasta as well. I was going to add spinach as well, but I forgot to get that out of Publix. So I am just cutting these up, throwing away the ends, and preparing them to add to the pasta. So as I'm doing that, I'm cutting it on the plate, as you can see, the Scooby-Dooby-Doo plate, because I can't find the cutting board right now. So I had to improvise. You guys know how it goes. So I'm just adding that to my bowl with my peppers, cutting up the rest of the asparagus as well. So I can go ahead and add that while I'm getting everything prepared. So these are the pastas that I'm going to use. They were actually buy one, get one free in Publix. If you are going to buy any kind of seafood or any meat, I do suggest going to Publix. Their stuff is always good and fresh. So that's where I got that from. So right now I'm just going to go ahead and rinse them and go ahead and put them in hot water so I can put them on the stove and get them ready to boil. It is best not to overcook the pasta as well. You don't want your pasta too soft or too hard. So I'm going to go ahead and put that on the stove as we speak. And I am going to go ahead and add a little bit of oil to the water just to give it a better moisture so it doesn't stick. I like adding oil to it because it doesn't stick to the bottom of the pot. And it just comes out more. It gives a more better version, I would say, to that when you add the oil to it. So I'm going to go ahead and add the oil and let that sit there and boil. So that was vegetable oil that I did go ahead and add to the pasta as well. So here I go, just cooking down the shrimp and the chicken, letting it, and I'm going to put it to sit there for at least 10 to 15 minutes. That way it just gets color and it cooks the proper way.
Moments later.
So here is after 15 minutes later, I'm going ahead and the peppers and the asparagus. And I'm going to go ahead and mix that up and let that sit for a little bit. And then I'm going to add something else. I let that sit for a while. I went ahead and added some mushrooms to that. And all I'm going to go ahead and do from here on out is just mix that up. Let that proper cook and get in there. We want to make sure the mushrooms are well cooked as well. We don't want to be eating raw mushrooms. So we definitely want to make sure that is well cooked. So I'm just mixing that up. Okay, so once that's done, I'm going to go ahead and add my pasta to an empty pot. I am going to put that pot on low because I don't want to burn it. So I'm just going to go ahead and add that pasta. Once I add the pasta, I'm going to add all the shrimp, chicken, mushrooms, and peppers with the asparagus all mixed together into the pasta. So that can get mixed in together. So I'm just going ahead and adding that in there. The pot is a little heavy. So I'm slowly adding that in there. As you can see, as I'm pouring it, nothing's sticking to the pot. I made sure I washed it carefully so nothing sticks or burns too much. So I'm gonna go ahead and mix that up. Just mix it up as well as you can all together. So I'm mixing, I'm mixing, I'm mixing. So we wanna make sure that is well mixed together with all the shrimp and chicken mixed into that pasta very well. I'm just turning down the stove just a little bit more because I don't want it to burn since I haven't added the sauce as yet. So I'm just mixing that slowly, making sure everything is mixed in well together. So here's how the pasta looks once I add the shrimp and pasta all together. So I am adding Parmesan cheese because if you know me, you know your girl loves some cheese. So I'm just gonna mix that in before I go ahead and add the sauce to that. So like I said, you can add whatever you want to this. I did go ahead and add some red pepper flakes as well because I love spice. Without spice, I feel like it's not enjoyable to me. It has to be burning my mouth.
So I'm gonna go ahead and mix that in. You can add more cheese or don't add cheese at all, depending on what you like.
Here's the Parmesan cheese that I did use to add to the pasta. And last but not least, I'm gonna go ahead and sauce it up. I'm adding my sauce, and here is the finishing touch of my pasta. You know I had to put cheese and parsley right on the top of my pasta because that is how I like it. So just remember to like, subscribe to my channel, and more videos will be coming your way. Thanks for watching.